Welcome dear students. In this video lecture, we are going to draw a problem on sections of solids under the topic cutting plane perpendicular to HP and inclined to VP. Let's go and solve the problem. This is what the question. Draw the sectional views and the true shape of the section of a cone of base diameter 60 mm and axis 70 mm. Resting on HP on its base, when a cutting plane perpendicular to HP and inclined to VP at an angle of 40 degrees. The cutting plane passes through the solid at 10 mm from the axis. So this also a problem very similar to the previous one. Instead of the cylinder, we are going to draw a cone and cut it. The cone is again resting on the HP on its base. So the base view, a circle, can be viewed only through the top view, and after that we needed to cut the solid with the given cutting plane, which is inclined to VP and perpendicular to HP. Let's go and solve the problem. Starting from the XY line, here the base view is a circle of 60 mm diameter. I just drawn it. And I need to mark its various generators. It's a cone, so it's having base generator points and apex point. So they are A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and O. And now I need to project the generator points and the apex point. The little approximation is there because of the lack of provisions in the software application. The axis height of the solid is 70 mm. At this height, I need to mark the apex point. It's O dash. And the base points are A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, E dash, F dash, G dash, H dash. And now I have to connect the slant generators. Thank you. And now we have to consider about the cutting plane. In this problem, it's given that the cutting plane is perpendicular to HP and inclined to VP. So the trace of the cutting plane as a line can be viewed in the top view, and its inclination with the VP is 40 degree, and the cutting plane passes through the solid at 10 mm from the axis. So the from the axis in the top view, that is from the point O, we needed to maintain a 10 mm gap between the cutting plane. So first I needed to draw a circle with a 10 mm radius to help me maintain distance between the cutting plane and the axis. Now the cutting plane is inclined at 40 degree to VP. This 40 degree inclined cutting plane passes through the solid 10 mm away from the axis in the top view. With a proper line format for the cutting plane, I have to cut the solid. Now I have to identify the cut points. Starting from the left extreme of the cutting plane, here intersection is there. This intersection is happened in the arc piece AB. Arc piece AB, one intersection is there. So I needed to award one cut point at this point, namely point P, and continue the travel with the cutting plane. Next, one intersection is there. It is a cone, so it's having slant generators, that is OA, OB, OC, OD, OE, OF and OG and OH, not like the previous problem. In the previous problem we worked with the cylinder, so there is no slant generators, only the lateral straight generators are there. So here this cutting plane intersecting with the slant generator OA at this spot. Here we needed to award a cut point. Say it is Q, and then continue our travel with the cutting plane. Again, one intersection is there. This is nothing but OH slant generator. So I needed to give one cut point here. It is R, and continue the travel. Again, one intersection. It is in OG slant generator. So I have to give one cut point here. Say it is yes, and then continue travel with the cutting plane. Finally, here one more intersection is there. It is on the arc piece FG, in the arc area FG. So here I am giving one cut point. Say it is T. So totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cut points are obtained in this problem. Before marking them in the front view, it's better to note down their address for confusionless marking in the front view. The cut points are P, Q, R, S and T. The cut point P is obtained in the arc piece AB in the base. And the cut point Q is obtained in the slant generator OA. OA, and the cut point R is obtained in the slant generators OH. And the cut point S is obtained in the slant generator OG. and the cut point T is obtained in the base arc piece FG. By using this address, we can mark the cut points in their respective location in the front view. First of all, we need to project them to the front view of the object. I am projecting the point P and point Q R S and T. Just I completed. Here, one by one we can mark. The cut point P's projector is going in this way. Whenever it is intersecting with the arc piece AB in front view, we can mark the cut point P dash. So here, this is the projector of point P from the top view, and it is intersecting with the A dash B dash arc piece in the front view at this point. So here I can mark the cut point P dash. P dash and the cut point Q, Q's projector, we need to mark Q dash whenever this Q's projector is intersecting with OA in the front view. In the front view, OA is here. So the cut point Q's generator projector is traveling in this way and it is intersecting with OA at this part. So here we need to mark the cut point Q dash. And the cut point R is here and its projector moving towards the front view. The cut point R's front view point R dash can be marked in the OH generator. Here the OH generator is passing and the projector of R is intersected with the OH generator at this point. So here I need to mark the point R dash. It's not looking fair. R dash. And similarly, when you project the cut point S from the top view towards the front view in order to mark the same in the slant generator OG in the front view, you can't mark it because the generator OG in top view as well as O dash G dash in the front view are perpendicular to the XY line. So it's not possible to mark it by just projecting the cut point from the top view to front view. So in that situation, we already know what to do. We have to do a simple work using our compass. Use your point O as center and point S as radius. Point S as radius. Draw an arc towards any slant edge, say here OE. So here I am marking a point, and from that draw a line towards the front view and drop the point in the same slant generator, that is in O dash E dash. After marking this here, draw a horizontal towards the generator OG where we need to mark the point R. In this way, we can mark the point R here. Point S in the OG generator. So let me to rub off the unnecessary things. And approximately I am marking it here. This is nothing but my cut point S dash. And then the cut point T we are projecting towards the front view and it's to be marked in the arc piece FG in the front view. Here F dash G dash arc piece is there. So it's intersecting with the projector of T in this part. And here I need to mark the cut point T. It is T dash actually. So after marking this five cut points in the front view, I need to connect them with the HB pencil. And one more thing you need to listen here. The cut points obtained in the base can be connected with the straight lines. And the cut point obtained in the generators, within the generators and generator to base, should be connected with the smooth curve. Okay. So I am connecting the cut points P and T dash, P dash and T dash with the straight line, because these two cut points are obtained in the base. But the cut point Q, R, S are obtained in the generators. So whenever I suppose to connect the cut point P, which is in the base, and the cut point Q, which is in the generator, I need to connect these two parties with the smooth curve only, with the HB pencil. And in the same time, if I suppose to connect two cut points which are all obtained within the generator, that is Q is in OA, R is in OH, these two cut points are obtained in the generators only. If I suppose to connect these two, then I need to connect with the smooth curve only. And the same time, if I suppose to connect the R and S, I need to use the smooth curve only. And to connect S and T, that is the cut point in the generator and the cut point in the base, I need to use the smooth curve. The smooth curves can be drawn with the help of your French curve tool. Okay. And after that, you have to highlight the retained portion in the front view also. In this front view, the portion which is to be darkened with the HB pencil is the retained portion in the base as well as the extreme generators of the core. You need not to darken the interior generators. Okay. That's enough. We need not to darken the interior generators. And one more duty is, after connecting the cut points with the smooth curve, a surface, a closed surface is obtained. This surface need to be hatched. Now we just completed the front sectional front view and a top view, and the only job remaining is to draw the true shape of the section. And this can be done by projecting the cut points from the top view perpendicular to the cutting plane towards the front view area. Now I am projecting the cut point P and the cut point Q, cut point R, cut point S, and finally the cut point T. Yes, at a convenient point, I needed to mark the axillary reference line X1, Y1. And now, for your understanding purpose, I am marking the cut points nearer to their respective projector. It's the projector of P and it is projector of Q and R, S and T. So now we have to mark the cut points P, Q, R, S just above this X1, Y1 by considering the distance between the cut points P, Q, R, S, T with respect to the X, Y line. So now the cut point P dash is obtained only in the X, Y itself. So in the new view, true shape of the sectional operation also, I need to mark the cut point P in the X1, Y1 itself. Here I need to mark it. This is nothing but the point P. And then point Q, just measure the vertical distance between the XY line, your reference line, and the point Q, and mark the point Q in the projector of Q with the distance same as that distance. And approximately I am marking here, it is nothing but the point Q. And the same way, measure the distance between the R dash and XY, mark the point R with the same distance between the X1, Y1. Here it is R. And measure the distance between the point S dash and XY, mark the point S in the projector of S with the same distance between the X1, Y1. Yes, and the point T is in XY only, so here also it can be marked in X1, Y1. After that, connect the points P and T, which are all obtained in the base, with straight line and connect the point P and Q with a smooth curve, and QR with the smooth curve, RS with the smooth curve, and ST with the smooth curve. And the area bounded by connecting the cut points can be hatched with two edge points. So this is nothing but the true shape of the section, and it's our sectional front view. Try this answer with the proper tools in your paper. Thank you.